Hi, Kathleen. Let's just start at the beginning, and why don't you tell us about this case?
For sure. Hi, Daryl. So, you know, this case broke up open on Facebook last December. A woman whose sister was in residential treatment at the Poundmaker's Lodge Healing Center in St. Albert posted some disturbing comments on her Facebook page about inappropriate behavior she was alleging by an elder, a man who was hired to be a spiritual advisor. And this facility is located just outside Edmonton in St. Albert.
Now, like you had just mentioned, you spoke to some of his alleged victims at the lodge in December. What did they say happened?
Right. So, and I should note that the lodge acted quickly after learning of the allegations on Facebook and terminated this man's contract. So he no longer works there. And now these were young women, First Nations women, who were seeking alcohol and drug treatment. They live at the center. And they say that when he was alone with them, they allege that he exposed himself and made other inappropriate comments and suggestions to them. So they contacted RCMP, and they also called me at APTN.
So what charges does he now face, and are they in relation to those women?
Yes, so a number of women swore complaints to the RCMP, and as a result, Gerald Twoteeth, he's 52 years old, he's charged with one count of sexual assault and two counts of indecent assault. And the reason RCMP issued a warrant for him is because they say they're unable to locate him, and they're hoping that through stories, the media, the public can help locate him.
So how did you find out about this and these charges?
Right. Well, I stay in touch with people who I've done stories with, and they were asking me if there was any update, if I'd heard any developments. And so I contacted RCMP this morning and was told that the warrant had actually just been entered into the system yesterday.
Okay. So what happens now with all of this?
Right. Well, so a warrant is out for Mr. Twoteeth's arrest, and if and when he is located, then that would start, the criminal justice process, where he would, of course, have an opportunity to apply for bail, and then eventually this may end up in a trial, and then the complainants would be able to tell their stories there. But for now, RCMP are hoping the public can help locate him and let them know about it by calling the Morinville RCMP detachment or Crime Stoppers.
All right, Kathleen, we'll leave it there. That is APTN's Kathleen Martens joining us.
Thanks, Daryl.